Good morning students, this is Pavan, your science master. Students, in this video I am going to talk to 7th standard students. Students, in the previous class we have talked about how you can make your own cell. Yeah, what was the explanation? Did you write the points, the learning points in your notes, students? I hope you did it. Thank you, and you just do like that. And also, most important thing, after you watch this video, you please give me a comment in the comment section. Then I can understand that you are watching the video. And also, you just give me your comment if you have any doubt, and you give me your comment if you have no doubt. I wanted to know that how you understood that video, okay? How you understood the concept. Okay, students, that's the most important thing. And also, if you give me a comment, I can understand that will be your attendance. Okay, students, if you don't give me a comment, and how I come to know that who is watching and who is not watching, okay, and who is learning out of it, who is learning something out of it, who is not learning something out of it, and all. I wanted to know that who are the students watching this video. Okay, students, that's the most important thing. And in this video, I would like to teach you about how a dry cell is constructed. You know, to understand this, how a dry cell is constructed. What's dry cell? You know, students, in the previous class, we have taken a chemical substance in injection bottles. Okay, what was the chemical name, you know, students? Shashi, tell me.
Sulfuric acid.
Very good, sulfuric acid. And what are the operators that you just mentioned them? What are the operators that we have taken in the previous experiment?
Rubber stopper.
Rubber stopper, okay.
Injection
bottles, very good.
Sulfuric acid.
And
LED bulb.
Zinc strip.
Copper strip
and copper, bits of copper wires. Okay, students, very good, Shashi. Will you all clap for this boy? Yeah, very good. And now in this video, what I'm going to teach you is how a dry cell is constructed. To understand how a dry cell is constructed, here you need to understand, here you need to do an activity. What's that activity? Students, you know, the cells that we use in our remotes that we use, we usually use a remote, right? And in that there are some battery cells, no? Yes, those are dry battery cells. Because, you know, there are some chemical substance, dry chemical substances present inside it. And what are present inside it? That we have to understand. Students, to understand what's there, what's actually there inside, you have to collect a battery cell which is already used but not in use right now.
Okay.
What I am asking you is to get a battery cell which is already used but not in use right now. And then what you have to do that, you have to break it. Okay, if you break it, you will see some parts. What are the substances present inside it? You know, if you remove the outer cover, you know, you will see a metal body. Okay, you remove just outer any plastic strip or something is there with some, you know, text with some information on the battery cell, you know. If you remove that, and you will see a metal body, okay. You will see a complete metal body, and if you break it, if you break and if you open completely, you will see a black powder particles. And also, you remove that powder part of that battery, dry battery cell, and you will see a solid rod, which is black in color. That's called carbon rod. And you will see one end of the carbon rod is packed or fixed with a metal cap. Okay, and then if you remove that, you will see only that carbon rod and a black powder part of it. That's carbon powder and some other mixture also present in that you cannot specifically you recognize that, but there is another chemical substance is mixed in that that I will teach you what is that and all. Okay, see students, the construction of dry cell, let me teach you first of all. Let me draw the diagram of dry cell first of all. Here, the title of this video is Structure of Dry Cell. Structure of dry cell. See here, I will draw the diagram and explain students. You please try to understand. You too draw. You can pause the video and you can also draw in your notebook, students. Yeah, students, if you keenly observe this, you will see some parts like, you know, this is metal container. This metal container is metal container. This metal container is nothing but zinc container. What is this? Zinc. Zn is the symbol of zinc. Otherwise, I will write the letters here. Z-I-N-C. Zinc. Students, let me write the name. Spelling, that is zinc container. Metal container is nothing but what? Zinc container. You know, students, this zinc container acts like negative. Negative charge. Okay, zinc container acts as a negative terminal. Okay? Negative terminal. And if you go on cutting it and you will see a powdery particles and the some chemical substances mixture, the mixture of chemical substances inside it, and here there will be what? Ammonium chloride paste. This is, you know, this part. I just draw lines like this. This is nothing but what? Shashi, can you tell me what is this?
Ammonium chloride paste.
Good. Ammonium chloride paste. And this is like a layer. One layer is ammonium chloride paste. And then what's next? Here, black particles here. This is nothing but, Shashi, can you tell me what is this? What might be that? Good, let me tell you, this is carbon powder. Carbon powder. This is another layer. Okay, and next you can see this is a solid metal. This is like a rod, solid part of this. It's not like powder, it's like a rod. It's like what? Can you tell me what is this, Shashi? कार्बन रॉड. What is this?
Carbon rod.
Students, if you observe at the top of this carbon rod, there is a structure like cap. What might be that?
Terminal.
Of course, very good. That's a terminal, but it's metal cap. Metal
cap.
See, Shashi, if you see this, this carbon rod and ammonium chloride and this carbon powder, it everything inside and it is sealed. Okay, this is the seal. Okay, what is this?
Seal.
Seal. It's everything sealed with a metal container, zinc container. Okay, right? Zinc container acts as negative terminal. You don't forget this. And what about this metal cap? It acts like a positive
terminal.
Very good. Acts like positive terminal. Remember, it acts like what?
Positive
terminal. Remember. See, here to generate electricity, there must be a positive and a negative charges produced. Okay? Here, how positive and negative charges are produced? Of course, this zinc container acts as a negative terminal and metal cap acts as positive terminal. Okay? Students, how this negative and positive charges are produced? You know, the mixture of chemical substances inside it, they get react. Okay? They get react to each other and they produce positive charges and negative charges. Students, positive and negative charges. Okay, students? Positive and negative charges are produced inside it. And all the positive charges are gathered at the carbon rod and they flow through this carbon rod. And all the negative charges are gathered at the surface of this metal container, and this metal container, you know, the base, if you connect something here, if you take a LED bulb like this, take an LED bulb like this and connect this positive and negative terminals of this LED bulb with a copper wires. One positive terminal with this positive terminal of this cap, metal cap to here, metal cap, the part which is part of this dry cell. And you have to connect this another negative terminal of the LED bulb with this metal container, you know, zinc container at the base of the dry battery cell. Then what will happen, you know, the negative charges flow here and positive charges flow through that, and then the flow of charges will take place, and then finally what will happen? Tell me, Shashi, what will happen?
The bulb will glow.
Very good. The bulb will glow. Okay? When the charge is flown, when the charges like negative and positive flow through these copper wires continuously, what will happen? The charges make the bulb glow. The flow of what? Flow of, just a moment, flow of charges. Yes.
Sir,
Shashi, tell me. Yes, good, tell me.
Sir, there are ions in this dry cell.
Pardon? Tell me once again.
There are ions. ions.
There are?
Ions.
Means ions.
Ions.
Yes, of course. Charges are nothing but ions only. Okay. Positive and negative. Positive ions are cations. Okay. Negative ions are anions. Okay, the ions and all you will study in your higher classes. Ions, you know, two types. One is plus, another one is minus. Ions are nothing but charges. Okay, charges only. Positive charge and negative charge. When they continuously flow through these copper wires, then only the bulb glows. Okay, got it? Yeah, this is how you can understand the structure of dry cell and how it functions as well. Okay, what are the parts present here, Shashi? Can you tell me? Metal container, how it acts as?
Negative terminal.
Very good, negative terminal. And what are the chemicals present inside it? Very good, ammonium chloride paste, and then
carbon powder.
And what else? What is this part of this dry cell?
Carbon rod.
And how, you know, the charges are produced? Because of the chemical reaction taking place between these chemicals inside. Okay, there will be some exchange of what? Exchange of ions taking place. Okay, that all you will study in your higher class, you just remember, that's it. Okay, now there is some chemical reaction taking place between these chemicals inside the dry cell. That is why they are producing positive and negative ions or charges. Okay,
okay,
and the positive charges reach to positive terminal of this carbon rod. And negative charges reach and gather this metal container, and they are flown through these copper wires out of it, and then the flow of these ions or charges make the bulb glow. And if it is kept connected and if it is glowing continually, what will happen after some time? Tell me what will happen then? No. You say that the bulb gets fused, right?
Yes.
No, that's not the point here. Actually, if it is continually working, you know, if it is continually working, what happens? The dry cell gets exhausted. Dry cell gets what?
Exhausted.
The dry cell gets exhausted, then what will happen? What will happen? There will be no more charges are produced. Okay? No more charges are produced. If there are no more charges produced, what will happen? The dry cell is said to be, okay, completely discharged. Okay?
Discharged.
The dry cell is said to be discharged, then we will throw it off. Okay? Very good, Asmi. Yeah, you mean what, you know, if you might have seen sometimes that exhausted battery cells are kept in hot sun, again it is getting charged and again it is working like that, right?
Yes, sir.
But it's not, you know, it's not with the chemical reaction taking place inside it. You know, it's actually because of the hotness, hot, you know, sun is hot, no? Sun is hot. If it is kept in hot sun, that heat of sunlight is converted into charges. Okay, understood, no? If you, you know, students, you too, please try to understand. You too experience this thing, you know, if remote cells or something, you know, if they are not working, you keep in hot sun and after some time, you'll see that they are working. But that's because of that heat energy again is converted into electric energy, you know. Very good, Shashi. Your doubt is excellent. You got your doubt cleared right now. And dry cell converts chemical energy into electric energy. Here, one important thing, conversion of heat. No. Conversion of energy point that we will see in the next class, but how energy is converted. You know, in the previous videos we have talked about heat and temperature chapter, you know, heat and measurement chapter. In the chapter we have talked about heat is a form of energy and that is converted from one form to another, right? Here, these are the chemical substances. They are with some energy. They produce, they are with some chemical energy. The chemicals are with what? Chemical energy. But this chemical energy is converted into electric energy. Yeah. How this is happening, you please try to understand with this experiment. How energy, conversion of energy is taking place here. Chemical energy is converted into electric energy. And here, if there is no chemical energy, if the battery cell is discharged or exhausted, then you keep it in sunlight and you will get little more heat energy from the sunlight, and the heat energy makes this remaining already which are exhausted, the chemicals which have no more charges in it, it little stimulates it. It stimulates a little bit and then that electricity is again produced, but not like, you know, new battery cell. The new battery cell produces more electricity than comparing to the electricity produced by after, then the electricity produced after you keep it in hot sun. Okay? So that's a different story. And anyhow, you came to know that the energy is converted, chemical energy is converted into electric energy in this dry battery cell. Okay? I hope you all understood this concept, how dry cell is constructed and how the construction is and what are the parts involved in this construction of dry cell and how to connect them and what is conversion of energy and what is dry cell. You know, gets exhausted, no more charges are produced. That means discharge. What is positive terminal and what is negative terminal. So these are the points that you have studied in this video, students. I hope you all understood this video. I want you to write the understood points in your notebooks. The points that what you, after you watch this video, you understand some points, no? You please mention the points that what you have understood in your notebook and present it in our WhatsApp group. And also you give me a comment in the comment section. I keep the comments on to my videos. Please give me a comment in the comment section with your doubt. And that will be your attendance as well. Okay? Thank you for listening. Thank you one and all.